Wait a second. So he says in this one, so you're voting for A? So wait a second. Let's go back to the previous one. So the force down on the spring, I thought we agreed was mg, right? What's the force up on the spring? Mg? What if it's not? Demo time, okay. Pretend there's the metal. Nah, it'll break. Okay, so there's a mass hanging here, okay? It's pulling down, and now I'm going to stop pulling down. Wait, let me try that again. All right, so I'm holding it up, but that gets tiresome, so I only want to pull down with mg. Something must be wrong with my spring. I would argue that in order for that spring to stay put, the same tension must be applied to both ends. Otherwise, what'll it do? Accelerate, right? The net force on the spring has to be zero. So if we come over to here, what's the net force on the spring? Zero. As far as the mass on the right is concerned, what is the force of the string on the mass? How much? Mg? Gravity is pulling down with mg, so what's the tension force? If it's not mg, what will happen? It will accelerate. So this one is pulling up on the mass at mg. Then it goes over to pulley. What's the pulley doing? It changes the direction of the force. Is it true that the tension on this side is the same as the tension on that side? Oh, that was a tragedy. All right. So the tension on this side of the spring is mg. The tension on that side of the spring is mg. Therefore, the elongation of the spring is mg over k. So the answer is A.